doing? Welcome back to my channel. So happy to be seeing you here. So today's episode is going to be a bit different than the other episodes because today I'm going to answer the most frequent question that is asked on Instagram, and you will find out the question very soon. In the meantime, make sure to subscribe, make sure to turn on the notification button so you don't miss any of the new episodes. So let's get started. So by looking at my photos, most of my followers ask, how do you manage to be so happy? Haven't you ever been confronted with any challenges in your lives? Why are you always so positive? My response is, trust me, I've encountered number of challenges. You know, I don't have enough fingers to count them. But at the same time, you know, whenever I'm confronted with a challenge, I never see it as a trial or a punishment. Rather, I see it as a lesson. So just as in school, you know, if you fail a test, of course your teacher is gonna make sure that you retake it until you ace it, right? And that's how you progress on to grade 2, 3, 4, etc., until you graduate. So that's how I see life. Life is designed in a very similar form. So you are given a trial. If you don't acquire the lesson the first time around, life is going to make sure to bring it to your life, but intensify its level even more, a little more. So until you learn the lesson behind the obstacle, it will be continuously coming into your life just like a cycle. So my advice to you, whenever you are confronted with a challenge or an obstacle, never look at yourself as the victim. You are not a victim. The lesson is here in order to bring out the best in you, in order to make you grow stronger. It is going to guide you to a path or towards your purpose. So in life, you know, we usually meet people who come into our lives, and within like a month or two or a few years later, they disappear. And oftentimes when that happens, we fall into a state of depression or stress or etc., all these negative emotions. But let me tell you one thing. Always look at people and situations as a guide. So for you to get from point A to point B, a certain someone enters your life. So when that person stops serving their purpose, they leave the scene. Just like in a movie, actors come and go. People are actors in our lives. So from point A to B, someone will guide you and let you go. From point B to C, someone else will enter your life, and so on until we move to the final destination. Now, what I want to share with you today is something very profound, something very magical, something that I've used in my own life, and it's created the miracles, honestly. Whatever I share in my vlogs, I share based on not only theoretical knowledge, but practical knowledge. I share everything that I've actually tested in my own life. So make sure you get a pen and a pencil, because today I will just give you the basic foundation of an amazing forgiveness ritual. It's called Ho'oponopono. It's a Hawaiian cleansing ritual that helps you get rid of negative emotions, negative baggage, negative memories. Now, let me ask you one question, and if you have another answer, make sure you leave it in the comment box below and I'll take a look at it. What do you think is the biggest human enemy? What do you think? It's memory. In my opinion, it is memory, because every action that we take is usually tied to the memory that we have. If we do something out of anger, it's usually tied to a negative memory that we carry from the past. And in order for us to build a life that is satisfying, that is filled with joy, we must first and foremost learn to forgive. Now, there's a misconception. When people often tell you to forgive, we automatically say, no, why are we supposed to forgive X, Y, and Z? They've done me wrong, they've mistreated me, yada, yada, yada. I mean, we're human beings, we're very good with excuses. But listen, when you are forgiving someone, you are getting rid of the negative baggage yourself. You are cleansing yourself, you are purifying yourself, and you are cutting the chain from the past. It does not matter whether you've had a bad encountered a bad situation with a significant other, family member, boss, it does not matter. You can fix the situation by forgiving, acquiring the lesson, and letting go. Now, when we talk about forgiveness, some people assume that when we're trying to fix the situation with, let's say, a significant other, there is a tension between you two and there is no way that you are willing to forgive them. But listen, when we tell you to forgive, you are trying to get rid of the negative vibe. And there are various exercises that I will be sharing in my next videos. If you like these videos, then I'll be, of course, sharing more and more and going more in depth to share my knowledge with you, because I've read so many books on Ho'oponopono and I've done various courses and I've even acquired a certificate. So I'm a certified Ho'oponopono practitioner, basically. But yes, either way. And if you've attended my three pillars of manifestation, forgiveness is the first and foremost pillar. It is the most important pillar. In order for us to build a better life, in order for us to be satisfied with our lives, be in a state of harmony with ourselves, we must be able to get rid of all the negative baggage. Now, the Ho'oponopono ritual is very simple and effective if it is used in the proper manner, of course. I've tested this in my own life, and you're not going to believe. It fixed a situation which I was not able to fix in the course of 6 years. This ritual helped change it over 7 days, so it's fascinating. Now, the Ho'oponopono, what does that mean? The H-O-apostrophe-O means to make. Pono means right. So when you're doubling the word pono, you are doubling the effort you're going to put towards making things right. Now, there are four simple, very easy mantras that you can repeat. And it goes as follows. I'm sorry. Please forgive me. I thank you and I love you. Now, you might say, how in the world are these words, phrases, or mantras, however you want to refer to them, are going to change my life? Very simple. By repeating these mantras, you are basically accepting the situation as it is. You are perceiving this experience coming from the higher power above. And you understand that behind this lesson, something greater is coming. So when you repeat these four mantras, you can use it in any situation, be it to fix a financial situation, be it to fix a love life, your love life. Now, when you're repeating these mantras, if you're referring it to someone to fix a situation between a certain someone, you are basically not judging them. You are understanding them. You're showing empathy and sympathy rather than judging them and saying that you've done me wrong. So when you repeat these mantras, basically what you're saying is, I know you've hurt me, but I know it's not coming from your heart. It is coming from prior experience. Someone has hurt you, therefore you're hurting me. And I perfectly understand where it's coming from. Therefore, I am not going to judge you. Rather, I'm going to thank you for giving me this experience. You know, we often, as I mentioned, we often perceive all these trials, you know, obstacles as punishments, whereas they're in reality, they're leading us towards our purpose. I did not come to the stage overnight, unfortunately. It took me about 4 to 5 years. 4 to 5 years, now to think about it. It took me a very long time. I was the type of person who would never accept the situation as is. I always prefer choosing somebody else to blame, to show fingers, because at the end of the day, we're human beings and we like pointing fingers at others. We always, it's always easier for us to find somebody else to blame. But no. I decided to take matters into my own hands and change my own life by learning to forgive, by learning to let go. Because the trials that I've encountered in life, honestly, I do not want them to repeat and come back to my life. So I prefer to acquire the lesson, to thank the universe for giving me that lesson, and to grow and learn from it. So at the end of the day, from every experience, you know, you grow stronger and you grow wiser. So I've learned to thank the situation, and I would recommend you to do the same. Today, I'm not going to dive deep into this Ho'oponopono ritual, but if you'd like to hear more, make sure to hit a big thumbs up, leave a comment, and make sure to subscribe because I'll be sharing more of my life experiences with you. And yes, I will just refer to this as my corner of wisdom. Well, I hope you enjoyed today's session and make sure to stay tuned.